to the next episode. Barbecue with Greg.
Smell the smoke. The time is here for Barbecue with Greg. Your friendly mate who enjoys a barbie. Barbecue with Greg. Tips and tricks you never thought of. Fish or chicken or pig or cow or sheep or bronze, he just knows how. Beer or whiskey or cider or pop, and sometimes Jaeger shots, Jaeger shots. Barbecue with Greg. Wrap up Biff and join the party. Barbecue with Greg. Sit right down, it's time to start. It's Barbecue with Greg.
Okay, attempt number 4 at ribs. So, because it's the silly season at the moment, my butcher's been closed, so I couldn't get a rack of ribs. So I got a thing of spare ribs. What I'm going to attempt to do is line them all, tie them together. Let's see how this works out. So I've already got this going. It's currently at 150, which is a bit hot. Close the vents down to half. Let that calm down. Wood chips have been soaking for about 20 minutes, so by the time that's ready, it'll be half an hour. It's hot. And get them a bit flatter. I was just checking to see if it had that sinewy stuff on the other side, and it does. So I'm just going to do the one side as educated by my good mate Nathan. Oh, damn, you couldn't see it. That went straight into the swish, man. Swish. Oh. Lemon and ginger tea for the win. It is 9 o'clock in the morning. Good. Right. Got the same 3 little pigs. 3 little pigs that I picked up before my local barbecues galore shut down. It was a sad day. And I know this time not to put too much on. It's too salty. Which is why you don't have to do it overnight. So I read that if your salt, your rub is a salt heavy rub, you do it just before you're about to put it in. Otherwise you start to cure the meat because of the salt.
Makes sense
to me. And I'm the guy doing it. So, yeah. This little dispenser thing only got me. Pretty happy with it. One trip in and out from the kitchen. It's the dream, man. It's the dream.
Now it's a bit windy out here.
Probably put too much, but you know, it is what it is. Secondary seat for the win. So the plan is, once this temperature comes down, it's coming down very soon. Very soon I'll be opening up the bottom door down here. Let me show you this bottom door, which I had to do some repairs on. That's why the handle's in a different position than the other. Chuck all the wood chips. Good old wood chippies, which I just poured all over my leg. And I'm going to smoke them intensely for 30 minutes. Then I'm going to wrap them in foil, put some cider in there, and cook them for 2 hours. And then unwrap them, put the barbecue sauce on, and let it get all sticky, as Nate was educating me when he did ribs here. And hopefully they turn out fucking delicious, man. Fall off the bone goodness. And that will be my lunch today, because Ange is at work. There's no ribs here. There's no ribs. Wood chips down. That's hot. Last time as a practice run, I didn't realize, but the water had actually evaporated. So I've got to stay on top of that this time too. Starting to smoke up. Right. Here we go. Get them on. No time like the present. Here we go. Smoking. Oh man, that makes me happy. Alright. Yeah. I'll check back in when I put some more wood chips on. Alright, so the smoke has pretty much just stopped, and I said I was going to smoke them intensely. So that's what I'm going to do. That smoke stopping took about 15 minutes. Lasted about 15 minutes. Oop. One thing I noticed straight away was I put too many in, so the smoke was coming out a little smouldery looking, rather than normally. I would say you don't want it to look blue because it's burning whatever you're cooking, but that's when you're doing it with the actual fat causing the smoke, not the wood chips. So with the wood chips you want it to be blue. Smoking, re-chipping. This time I'm actually gonna top up the water as well. blaze up. I'm gonna light you a motherfucking fire.
Okay, so while that's doing its last smoke sesh, I'm going to put 3 sticks in. I'm going to prepare, using the original tray, some foil for the wrappage. Shut up. It's over 250 Fahrenheit now. It's pretty good at keeping temperature though, this thing. It doesn't fluctuate too much. Okay, it's been 30 minutes. The temperature has just dropped now down to about 100 degrees Celsius. So I'm going to take the smoked ribs off. Oh, they look pretty good. Alright. Let's set those aside for a second. So I think because I put water directly under the tap, why it lowers the temperature a bit. And I'm going to chuck some more heat beads on. Right. I'm down to the wire on heat beads, something like me. I've only got a couple left, which I'll need for the marinade part. I may have to go for a walkies and buy some more. Okay. Now while that sorts itself out, I don't mind cooking in 100 degrees Celsius. It just means I'll cook them for longer than 2 hours if the temperature doesn't go any higher. Ain't no thing, but a chicken wing and a string. No side is coming out. Now it's just a matter of checking temperature and getting water and stuff. I probably will risk it and go to the shop and get some more heat beads, because I want to get that thing back up to about 150 degrees when I'm putting the marinade on at the end. Reminds me, I better set timer. We'll set timer, else we'll fork up ribs. 2 hours. Alright, check you later. Be closer to lunchtime. I'll be having a beer. Okay, so I'm pretty fucking impressed with this thing. So I took Sophie for a walk. Come back, it was still hovering around 100 degrees. Put some water in. Went out again, went to the shops. Got some heat beads and some other bits and pieces. Come back, it's only just under 100 degrees. So it's holding its temperature very well. So my plan has changed a little bit, as my plans tend to do. I'm just gonna top up the water again. Thank you. roughly 30 minutes to go before I take them off and put the marinade on. What I'm going to do is load it up with heat beads again. Possibly go a little overboard. Never know with me. But I want to crank the heat back up during this last 30 minutes. And then I'm going to re-smoke. I'm going to smoke for the last 30 minutes where I was talking about where I'm going to have the marinade getting sticky. I'm going to smoke it as well. Again. The beauty of this is that they can't possibly be overcooked, but not at this point anyway. It's actually cool enough for me to touch that handle without gloves on. So I need to crank this up. Alright, I'll let it do its thing. It's pretty close to 12 o'clock now. You know it's true. Fucking wind's picking up. And Sophie's barking like, fucking bitch! Even though I said sit, but that's fine. Alright. Ready for crankage. I reckon. Sophie, sit. Sit. Drop. Good girl. Chunky bit. See where that one even went. This excess juice. There's a lot more juice in there than when I originally poured that cider in. Where did I pour that, you may ask? I poured it into the wood chip sink because I can't be bothered with Sophie going ape shit trying to fucking lick up the dirt, the pork flavored dirt. Ooh, that smells pretty good. Not as classy as Nate. I don't make my own barbecue sauce. Not saying I never will, just saying I haven't yet. Just using old stubs. Old stubs, same one you've seen me use before. Interesting because it was not a rack. Some of this barbecue sauce is going in through the cracks. That could work out to be something magical or something shit. We shall find out. Alright, get it back on. Get it back on the smoker. So, just before New Year's, well it's New Year's Eve, just before New Year's, I was right the first time, my mate Luke coming over, and I thought, fuck, just on the, coming over for a jam and a barbecue and all that shit. And I thought, just on the off chance that he wants to jump on the drum kit, I better get some practice in on the guitar. And I could not even make it through a fucking a verse of a Pantera song to start with. Probably about an hour and a half in, I was able to get most of the way through a Pantera song, but lots of fuck ups. My hand just all in here, man. It's fucking getting tight. So, I've made the promise to myself to practice at least for half an hour a day, every day. And you would have heard this one before. I was practicing Pantera before, but I didn't film it. Because apparently you get in trouble when you use other people's music. Whoops. See what I mean? Need that practice, man. Anyway, so I'm gonna set a bit of arm room here. So, let's play this one for you. It's one of my ones. Set a timer.
Oh no.
How long do you think I was playing that for? 7 minutes? Screw it. It's not even at 100 degrees. Can't possibly go dry. Can't possibly go dry, right? True story? Or last words?
Oh. Shh. Don't tell anyone. But here's a little bit of Pantera for you.
See how they look. wondering why I did that. It's to make sure the flies don't get in.
Moment of truth.
Well, it definitely could.
Oh, look at that. Oh, man.
That's the ultimate test. Here we go, Sophie. Here we go. Does it just pull away from the bone? Tender. Where are these flies?
A little too fatty, if you ask me. But that's because I didn't get a rack, right?
Very good, tastes good. Happy. I'm just going to be picking off the fat. I'm going to call that my first successful rib run. Do it with a rack next. Too much fat. I guess these are designed to just... I don't know what they're designed for. Be a pig's rib cage. That's what it's designed for.
On that note, I'm calling that a success. I'm gonna go inside and finish these away from these fucking flies. And watch the rest of the Chicago Bulls game. Boom!